We've been known for many years as being the leading manufacturer of engines. Commercial turf is very important to the Vanguard line. It's our biggest segment that we serve from our commercial business, and it's one of our focuses going forward. We want to provide the best possible engine we can on the equipment that we power. Designing an engine for the ZTR market from the ground up was really a great opportunity for us. We've gone out, we've worked with contractors, we understand what their needs are, and it allowed us to really focus in on making the best product we possibly could.
When we talk to contractors and fleet managers about what role the engine plays on a ZTR, they were very clear. They want durability, reliability, but most of all, performance. CCs, or displacement, really determine the capacity of that engine, the potential that that engine has to deliver torque to the blades. There's been a creep of displacement over time. In the last 4 years, the average displacement of a ZTR has risen 50 cc's. And we feel that having an engine at 810 cc's is the optimum position for this engine to be, not just for this year, but for many years to come.
This was a big step in durability for this engine. We wanted to earn the Vanguard brand. We had a good set of requirements. We knew what the specifications needed to be to make this into a good engine. So making it the ultimate ZTR engine, it's a great engineering challenge.
When I think about the features that I'm really most excited about on this engine, I start at the top of the engine. With 2014 ANSI standards coming in, our engineers were able to design this engine from a cooling airflow standpoint. And what we're doing is we're bringing way more air in through the top of the engine than our nearest competitor.
The whole cooling system is unique with the debris management. So the engine blower housing, the air filter system, all of that is new. The cylinder head and intake manifolds, the valve covers. So there's a lot of the components that bolt onto the engine that have been uniquely designed to go on the Vanguard engine. But the power head itself is really the key. So even the flywheel, with it being dynamically balanced, is unique to the Vanguard spec. We have a very well-established field test site down in Florida. They cut some pretty rough areas. The operators take a beating testing our equipment because we're looking to get them in dirty conditions. We're trying to cut long grass, we're trying to load it up, we're trying to shake the unit around. I mean, we're really trying to punish this engine. So by the time the engine launches, we'll have close to 100,000 hours of total test time on this design.
This plant is a V-twin focus factory. We make a lot of V-twins here, and we took advantage of our focus factory footprint here and looked at this commercial opportunity to basically say, you know, this 810 fits right in our sweet spot of our competencies of this plant. That 810 was given a lot of thought and consideration. It will be our first domestic commercial engine plant. So all the advantages of having a facility in North America for our North American customers, quick shipments, quick turnaround. This facility had the space. It's part of the family, product focus family. So perfect fit for us here in Auburn. Obviously, this is a Vanguard product. Vanguard tolerances, Vanguard designs. We took all that into account. You know, as you come through the process and get into the assembly area, we have taken a very specialized approach to how we assemble these engines. It's a kind of a craftsman approach. It's not a mass produced process. And that's what the commercial engine customer really expects. These things, reliability, durability, we know what they expect, and we're here to meet those criteria and build them a great product. And you know, when we walk through the assembly line, we have taken the process from front to back. And then we said, for the requirements to work on this line, we want you to go out and get this Master Service Technicians certification. And these folks are talented in hydraulics, pneumatics, industrial controls. They are our top guns in our manufacturing operations. We want to create a relationship between the technician and the engine that they have assembled and packed in the box. That's their engine. They're proud of it. They're going to be connected to the customer. And we think that that relationship and the pride that they have, their skills that they have, they're going to knock it out of the park. This is going to be a product that we're going to be very proud of, our customers are going to love, and you know, we got a process set up around that.
So when we began this process, we really had to contrast back to what we do in traditional manufacturing here at Briggs. this line had to be a little bit different. We wanted to have an all-encompassing team of technicians, and that's really a self-directed work team. They take ownership of it from start to finish, and we recruited the best. Combined, the three that we chose have 35 years of professional engine experience. Well, we begin the process with our CNC machines, our turning centers. Those are state-of-the-art, really the first of their kind here at our plant. We'll use CMM gauging to inspect the parts when they come off of those. Throughout the line, we've got a lot of DC systems. You go from your air tools, which were really the way of the past, where you just torque down a bolt and you have to check it after the fact. All of our DC controls throughout the system, they go through and they'll torque. They're very accurate, they're very repeatable, they're very durable. Every single torque that's put onto a bolt will be captured and data logged and cataloged and tied back to the serial number of that engine. We'll do our error proofing. You'll do a torque to turn on the engine, so you'll validate that all your features are put in properly, and then you'll power test the engine. It's absolutely rewarding that we're going to be building engines that are going to be out there, they're going to last thousands of hours, they're going to be built right here in Auburn, right here at Bridge and Stratton.
As I look at what we've done with this engine as a team, I'm very proud of what the entire organization has done in coming together in developing a product that I believe will be second to none.
We have deliberately not rushed the 810 into the Vanguard brand. It had to get there through development testing and lots of testing to get it to the point where it meets all of the Vanguard performance and durability criteria to earn that Vanguard label.
One thing that really makes me feel proud and confident of this engine is how holistic the approach has been to manufacturing. At Auburn, Alabama, we've got the right product, we've got the right people, and we've got the right process going into the combination of building this product.
It really is about the contractor at the end of the day. It's about what they get out of the relationship with Briggs & Stratton. It's about that piece of power equipment they buy, powered by a Vanguard. And we want to make sure that they have the best experience they can with our Vanguard engine.